Hey, what's up, hams and hamettes? This is Hoshnasi, KI6NAZ. Not too long ago, I started to research portable, luggable, vacation-type antennas. Something you could maybe set up on a beach. In my case, I dragged this one up to a hill in California. And also, I wanted something that I can use for the 2018 AWRL Field Day. The antenna I went with was the MFJ Big Ears, the 2289, MFJ product number 2289. And part of the reason for that is the antenna kind of hit all my bullet points. It goes up to 40 meters and all the way to 50 megahertz as far as its receive and transmit capability. And it can go all the way up to 1 kilohertz in power with the transmitter. I don't have that much power, but it's really nice to know that I could use that if I was working with my club or some other groups that had way more power at their disposal. So the kit itself is made up of a couple of pieces. Primarily, there's two aerials that are connected to a 45 degree dipole center that has a ballon inside. And there's also a loading coil. And the loading coil, in conjunction with shortening the vertical leads, is how you change the tuning for the radio. Also, there's a stand, which is three separate pieces, one metal base, and then two fiberglass poles that interconnect to each other. The stand is really nice. The stand could be used for all different kinds of antenna applications, not just the big ears, and I would use it for pretty much anything I needed. My particular model came with a nice tote bag that had separate compartments for the telescoping aerials, the center mast, and then three nice pockets in the front, which allowed me to put the kind of center connector, the loading coil, and then I also like to throw my analyzer in there occasionally, depending on what I'm doing. As of the time of recording this video, I've used this antenna on multiple occasions. One such occasion was activating San Juan Hill in Yorba Linda, California. I was able to make contacts on 40, 30, and 20 meters very simply, with the longest being all the way in Pennsylvania. Very good, and that was single sideband. One of the better points for this antenna is its field setup and use. It's very easy to set up. Basically, just put that tripod down. I use a stake, kind of right in the center, get that stake down as far as you can, and then I use some twisty ties to pull it down as much as I can. That way, if you get some wind side to side, it won't topple the antenna over, which for this antenna, if it topples over and lands on any one of those aerials, you're definitely gonna bend it, damage it, break it, whatever. So try to avoid that and try and guy it down or stake it down. After that, just take the fiberglass poles, run them down the tripod, which they're very firm, very sturdy, and then attach the center connector with the two leads, the 45 degree angle leads, and then your lead for your coax. So there are a couple of ways to use the aerials and the center connector. It is my understanding if you just use the telescopic aerials alone with the 45 degree connector, you're only going to be able to get up to 20 meters. If you want to add the 40 portion of the antenna, you're going to need to use the loading coil. Now, how you do that is you extend the aerials all the way out with the loading coil. With the loading coil, there's a separate wire with an alligator clip, and you're basically going to clip the alligator clip on one of the many circles or coils, and that shorts the coil out and reduces or lengthens the total length of the antenna. I found that about 14 loops is what you need for 40, and you need none of the loops basically for 20, and you can actually shorten the vertical a little bit, the telescopic aerial, just a little bit to really fine tune that SWR. Now on 20 meters, I can easily get the SDR down to 1 to 5 or 1.2 to 1. That's really good. Very good. It operates really well. 40, pretty much the same. Like I said, you use the alligator clip on the loop, and if you want a kind of bigger movements, you can fine tune it by adjusting the aerials itself. So you don't need it, but I recommend an antenna analyzer if you have one. Makes the setup a bit faster. In the case of my kit, the Zygu X5105, has a built-in SWR meter, like a visual graphical meter like this analyzer does, which really helps to get the SWR right. Way to go. It's the absolute way to go if you have that capability. So like all of my reviews, I tell you a little bit about what I didn't like on the product. And what I don't like on the MFJ 2289 is it can be a bit flimsy. It's susceptible to wind, so you need to have stuff in your kit to make sure that you can make sure that it's tight down, because it will break. Now, that being said, all other antennas have a very similar problem. They all can be pretty fragile, particularly the freestanding ones. With that said, the MFJ stand that I have with the kit is actually very nice. It's very sturdy, and I'd easily be able to guide that down. My reviews and my recommendations are based off a certain type of role or mission that you're trying to accomplish. For me, the 2289 is a mission critical portable antenna. It's not exactly soda portable, although I did drag it over 6 miles to the soda activation of San Juan Hill. It is heavy. The stand is very heavy. With that said, it's totally doable if that's your sole goal or if you were going to put something larger than a QRP transceiver through it. Absolutely, this would be a perfect one-man show radio for Field Day or some other event like National Parks Online. Any soda hill or summit that you're going to that's kind of a walk-up, as they call it, if it's less than a quarter mile, there's no problem. You can carry this in the tote bag and just, you know, get set up really quickly. So major points for being able to set it up quickly. The tuning and SWR matching is very, very easy, particularly if you have something like an antenna analyzer or radio that has a nice graphical SWR meter. And given its price of under $400, it's an economical option for people who want to keep the price within a certain budget. I value that. Okay, and that'll do it. Thank you so much for watching. If you have not already, please subscribe and hit that ding-a-ling bell so you get notified every time I post. I do a live stream every Friday at 7 p.m. Pacific Standard Time where we talk about everything ham radio news and pushing forward our knowledge and getting better in ham radio, what we like to affectionately call moving forward with ham radio. We've also got a Facebook page, the Ham Radio Crash Course. There's a Discord and there's a Patreon where I give out my newsletter every month, and there's some other perks too. If you're interested in any of those things, the links are in the description. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll talk to you later.